Good morning, all my dear students. Good morning, all my viewers. So now I am going to give a detailed information about a new topic, that is about what the daffodil. So before it, you just watch this video, because I am saying directly to all my viewers and the subscriber that you know that some of the teachers, many of the teachers, they were actually giving you a what whiteboard classes. Some of the teachers, they were also giving you what that, you know, that a sort of you that is the smart class, whiteboard class and the classroom teaching. So now apart from that classroom teaching, apart from that the whiteboard class, your whiteboard teaching, so all the classes, so now you will get a perfect teaching that what I am going to give you that. So this is actually a natural beauty and natural teaching to you, a perfect atmosphere that will suit to you and that will relax your mind. Okay, so because as I am going to give you a details about that one poem, you know that, so that is related to the natural images. So different natural images that has already been sketched out by that what William Wordsworth. Okay, while William Wordsworth has not done any kind of mistake while narrating this poetry, because Wordsworth is actually, you know, that a poet of nature, and he is called as the naturist, right? So why he did not want to leave that nature, you know that? So he wanted to live on the nature forever. So that's why Wordsworth had just narrated this beautiful poetry. And the first stanza of the poetry, I will give you a perfect detailed information about that first stanza. So in the first stanza, what the poet is actually giving you, that a perfect message to you. What is that? Now, different questions that are coming to our mind. So would that natural beauty is important, or that is that natural beauty important, or the materialistic life is important? So now we have to segregate, we have to differentiate that two kinds of life, and how the human beings, they are maintaining that life. So this kind of things that is being narrated in this poetry, and in the first stanza, what we are actually giving you, said I will give you a perfect detailed information. Let's see that first stanza, what has been written by the William Wordsworth. Let's see that. And I am reading out that stanza, then after I'll make you understand. The first one is that what? I wander lonely as a cloud that floats on high over wells and hills when all at once. Here the poet is actually saying that I wander lonely as a cloud. So here, you know, that different personifications are also there. You know that the cloud has already been personified, you know that. And the poet is saying that I am wandering lonely as a cloud. That means as the clouds that moves on the sky, lonely, right? So likewise, the poet is actually moving, traveling above the high, above the vales and mountains. Here vales means valleys and the mountain, right? Because he wanted to live lonely, and you know that, because he did not want to live in the materialistic prosperity or materialistic life. So that's why he is saying that I am wandering lonely on the high, above the hills and the mountains, like a cloud. And another thing is that what? So another thing is that in the second line it said, I saw a crowd, a host of golden daffodils beside the lakes beneath the trees. I saw a crowd, a host of golden daffodils. So this is, you know, that this line suggests that host of daffodils. Whenever I am saying that host of daffodils, it is called as the group of daffodils, because host directly refers to the what? A group of daffodils. And the poet saw at once a group of daffodils, right? Here, you know that the poet has been enamored by the beauty of that daffodils. And he said that directly, he says, what? I saw a crowd, a host of golden daffodils. I saw a crowd. Crowd means, here it suggests or it refers to a group of daffodils. Okay, crowd doesn't mean that a group of people. Actually, the group of people here is not that crowd. Crowd is actually a group of daffodils. He has seen a group of daffodils, a number of daffodils. Another one is that a host of golden daffodils besides the lake, beneath the tree, fluttering, dancing in the breeze. And he has seen all these daffodils. Where he has seen? Now a question. Where he has seen that daffodils? He has seen that daffodils, okay, beside the lake, under the trees. These are the, you know, besides the lake and under the trees. So these are the, you know, these are the natural images. I said in the first of my video, that's what different natural images that are being drawn by the poet. So these are the perfect natural images that the Wordsworth, actually the poet, okay, has never left, okay, and has never left to give a beautiful shape into this poetry. And next after it is saying that what, beside the lake, beneath the tree, fluttering, dancing in the breeze, fluttering and dancing. So that, what do you mean by fluttering? Fluttering means it is a kind of true and false motion. It is a kind of backward and forward. That means what? When the cold wind that blows, okay, during that time, what happens that, you know that, that all these daffodils that are fluttering with the coming, with coming into the contact of that, what the cold breezes. Cold breezes here, it suggests that cold wind. So perfectly it is what? When the cold wind that blows, okay, so with the coming, with coming into the contact of that cold winds, that all these daffodils, actually they are fluttering and they are also coming. Sometimes they were going to the backwards and sometimes they were going to the upwards. This particular backward and upward movement is called as what, the fluttering. So now in this stanza, what I am going to give you a message, you know that the poet wanted to live in the beauty of that, what, beauty of the daffodils. He did not want to live in the materialistic prosperity. He did not want to live in the materialistic life. He wanted to desert all this materialistic life, because all this materialistic life is valueless. Because I know that where we get that peace. So we got that perfect peace in the image, in the abode of what? Natural beauty. So that's why I just took an attempt to give you a very good shot and very good video about that natural images. And all this, where I am standing, so all these are natural images, right? These are the beautiful trees and this is a perfect atmosphere. This is a perfect atmosphere to give you all these details about this poetry, right? So listen that. So this is all about the poem, right? And that has been written beautifully, magnificently by the poet William Wordsworth. And here you just have to write down all this word, the word and meaning. You can also, if you don't want to, listen that, you can write down also. Or all the students, they are not interested, okay, they may not take interest, okay, to see for a long period of, okay, besides you can write down all these hard words. So here it is that wondered means you can write down it, you can also see that, you can also listen that. Wonder means actually roaming, okay, this is called as the wandering. So next starter, it is called as the float. Float means actually if you are flying on the sky, it is suggests that what, the float. And next it is also saying that ki crowd. Here it is crowd suggest means it is not the group of people, it is actually a group of daffodils, okay, so that is called as the crowd. And when we are saying that host is a group of daffodils and crowd is also a group of daffodils, and so what makes it sense? So perfect sense it is, you know that. So whenever the poet was moving on the high hills, whenever the poet was moving on that, what, the valleys, right? So he has seen a group of daffodils, and that is, and he has been enamored by the beauty of that daffodils. Next it is what? It is that, so fluttering means going backward and forward. So this is all about the fluttering. So after all, this is a very good poetry. And if you wanted to like my video, you can subscribe my channel, you can like and you can share all this channel. So many of the readers and many of the students, they can also share and they may be benefited from this video. Thank you after all. Okay, once again, if I will make another video, then it will be a very good to you, suit to you, right? Thank you.